Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Kingdom Planting. In that, we are studying topic, why did Mendel selected pea plants for his experiment? Now Mendel was a scientist who laid down the basis for genetics, and Mendel was Gregor Mendel. Why did he select Picum sativum or pea plant for his experiment? Let's study today. Why did Mendel select only and only pea plant for his experiment? Now pea plant has a scientific name which is Picum sativum. Now Gregor Mendel was the father of genetics. He is not present now, he is obviously dead, and he is currently known as or will be known as father of genetics always. Did he get Nobel Prize for his findings? No, he did not. Before his experiments were did, and later on he was called the father of genetics. It means once Mendel died, afterwards he was called as the father of genetics. Now why does he choose pea plant or Picum sativum for his experiment, and what was this great work he did? Mendel or Gregor Mendel was from Georgia, and the words which you study today, hybrid, allele, genetics, homozygous, heterozygous, these all words were coined, or you can say brought into picture, by Mendel even before the advent of microscope and PCR. Isn't that great? Now why Mendel used pea plant or Picum sativum plant for his experiments, we are going to find out. There were so many plants available, so why pea plant? Because one of the reasons could be that pea plants produce progeny much faster. They produce the F1 progeny, F2 progeny. Hybridization of pea plants were easy, or hybridization could be done at very faster pace. This pea plant produces flower, fruit, and even pods to compare, and it was easy to grow, easy to maintain. So let's find out why does he use Picum sativum plant for his genetics experiment. Basically, if I have to say in one line, throughout his life or throughout his career in genetics, Mendel wholly and solely did experiments on pea plant, whether it was monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, everything he did experiments on pea plant. Now why did Mendel selected pea plant or Picum sativum plant for his experiment? There was a reason why Mendel did that. He could have chosen any flowering plant or fruiting plant, but why pea plant? The first important criteria was that pea plants were easy to cultivate. Obviously, they were not big as the mango tree or not small as the grasses. They had a moderate height and they were easy to cultivate. They can be even grow in Georgia where Mendel stayed. Now pea plant has second thing. Pea plant had very short lifespan. You can say approximately 5 months or 4 months is the lifespan or life period of pea plant. So in a quarter of a year, he could cultivate pea plants number of times. Within 2-3 months, you can get pea plant pods. Even smaller pods can be seen, which is not possible in the case of a mango tree if you did that experiment on mango tree. Thirdly, the flower produced were bisexual. Now this was really good for Mendel's experiment. If you had a bisexual flower, a flower which has both anther and stigma present or embedded in a same flower, the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma and then to the female gametophyte would be possible quite easily, and then the progeny study could be made very easy. Now simple pollinations or one type of pollinations are very easy as compared to cross pollinations in which different flowers or different plants would be used. Pisces adapted plants showed well-defined contrasting characteristics. Now, if you have seen a pea plant or pea pod or Pisces adapted plant, you would notice that different pea plants have different genera of height. They're pod-shaped, or you can say the round-colored pod is sometimes wrinkled, sometimes round. Even the flowers are sometimes purple, sometimes white. The pea plant height could be tall or dwarf. Even the shape of the pea pod could be constricted or could be ringed. So there are different characteristics to study, and this made the study of homozygous, heterozygous alleles very easy and very rapid for Mendel. They produce fertile hybrids, and when I say fertile hybrids, it means the progenies that were produced in every generation could give rise to another progeny, and that's a very contrasting characteristics to find in animal kingdom for every plant. Every plant progeny is not capable of producing another progeny in that given span of time, but pea plant had that. And students, one of the most striking features why Mendel selected pea plants for his experiments were that pea plants or Pisces sativum could be self-pollinated as well as cross-pollinated. When I say self-pollinated, it means crossing between same type of pea plant, that is tall plants cross with tall plant, that's self-pollination. Or you can say pollinating a single bisexual flower on a single plant, that's self-pollination. And when I say cross-pollination, it means either using two different species or two different characteristics, whatever is the requirement. So that was the reason why Mendel selected pea plant and studied on pea plant and developed the various terms which we study in genetics in his time. The reason why Mendel is called father of genetics, because the whole and soul genetics which we study today and will be studying later down in our lives is or was started by Mendel, and a small, not so small also, the pea plant experiment or the Pisces sativum experiment. I hope students, you are now at least clear why Mendel selected pea plants for his experiments. Thank you.